Hi everyone, it's Carissa at Sprinkled with Glitter, and today I am going to be making some handmade tags in a hurry for my Christmas gifts this year. And I'm going to be using a few little cheats here, like I'm using these pre-cut tags. I'm also going to use washi tape. Now, washi tape is a really good cheat to use on some of these handmade projects that we're trying to get through. But right now, I am on call for work, and so I have to get through these really fast. I did want to show you, though, a few of these gold pins that I have on hand. Now, I found this Krylon 18 karat gold. This is a gold leafing pin, and I really love it. I also have the Zig Painty pin and the Pilot gold marker pin. Now, these are all kind of like a paint pin, so you want to shake them up really good. And I'm going to show you here just kind of how each of these write. Now, I'm starting out with the Zig Painty pin. Now, this has a really nice fine tip, and it's a really nice color gold. It's kind of maybe a little watery at first, so you got to make sure it's really shaken up really well. And this is the Pilot pin. Now, I'm going to write my name and a couple things here. Once again, this has a really nice fine tip. The gold is a little bit, it's a little dark for me. I like a little bit brighter gold, like a true gold. And so I'm going to show you here. This is the Pilot pin and the Zig pin. Now, my favorite of all of these pins is the Krylon 18 karat gold leafing pin. Now, I love this for adding detail, but it does have this really big chisel tip. So you're going to see me try to write something really small here. It's not going to work out so well because it does have this really nice big chisel tip. That's okay because I can find a use for this, but I did want to show you. And as I write this out, you can really see that this is a very true gold. It has a lot of metallic in it. It's really shiny when you hold it up in the light, and this is by far my favorite. So I'm going to kind of show this to you in the light, and you can see how much shine you get off of that Krylon. And so that is by far my favorite. I'm going to be using it on these tags today, but it's not something that you necessarily want to write a message in a card with or anything. So maybe that Zig or Pilot would work for something like that. So I'm taking this Krylon pin and I'm just going to trace around these tags. Now these tags are pre-made tags. They're from Michaels. And I really love the shape of them, but I thought they needed something to help them kind of jump off of the packages. Now my packages have a very kind of craft, natural look to them. They have like a candy cane stripe and I'm using raffia on them. So this is going to help them jump off of those packages, but still keeping that really kind of rustic kind of holiday feel. So you see, I've gone ahead and traced around a bunch of those, and this pin is really nice too because it dries really quickly. Now I'm moving on to creating the sentiment pieces for the front of these tags, and I'm just cutting a couple pieces of red cardstock. I'm doing two pieces at a time. This is saving me some time, and I'm cutting them to 3 1/4 wide by, 3/4 inch wide by 3 1/4 inch long. Does that make sense? I don't know if I'm making sense. I have holiday brain. I'm trying to get stuff done. So I thought I would originally kind of string these through on the other part of that whole part of the tag. So I went ahead and punched a hole in all of those with my crocodile. And then I'm grabbing stacks of these and I'm just cutting the ends into angles. Now I'm doing all this really quick and easy because, like I said, I have to get these done fast before I'm called into work. So now I'm getting them ready to kind of stamp here, and I'm just laying them all out on my surface. I'm going to be using a Simon Says stamp set for my sentiment. This is the Holiday Hellos, and I'm going to be using that Merry Christmas stamp. And I'm just going to ink it up in some ColorBox pigment white ink. Now, you have to be careful with this because it's a pigment ink and it will smear, but I wanted that white on red. I could have embossed these, but that would have taken a little more time. So if you want a really true white, you may want to emboss these. But this gives you a really, in the end, a really chalky look, which I think is kind of cool and kind of keeps with my rustic kind of Christmas theme. So once I got those all stamped, I set them aside to dry, and I am taking some of the chartreuse paper. This is from Paper Source. I'm cutting it into 2-inch wide strips so that I can use this Holly Punches die. This is from We Are Memory Keepers. This is going to save me a lot of time because it's going to cut 5. It would actually cut 6 if I had 12-inch long pieces of paper, but I only have 11. So it's going to cut 5 holly leaves at a time. Now, I tried to double up the paper here, and you're going to see that this die did not really do a good job of cutting through two pieces of paper at once. So I did end up having to cut these one strip of paper at a time, but that's okay because it really didn't take that long. And like I said, I'm getting 5 holly leaves out of each pass in my die cut machine. So that kind of makes it fast and saves time. Now I'm going to add a little washi tape. Now washi tape is a great way to add some pattern to these without having to go through and cut like little strips of paper and glue them on. I've already got adhesive, and this is where I get smart. I started working from the right to the left because then I can get the end where I want it and I can rip it off at the hole and I don't have to worry about it covering the hole because I'm going to be adding some string through that hole. Now I'm just adding this at an angle because you can see here when I go to add my sentiment strip, I'm going to add that at kind of an angle as well. So they're kind of going to be sprawling out from each other. I don't know a better way to put it. Now you can see here that I thought at first I would string my string through both the red piece and the tag piece, but my holly leaves were covering up some of my sentiment. So it was time to make an adjustment. And so what I did was I just pulled that out and used my holly leaf to cover up that hole. And I'm going to use my tiny attacher to attach those leaves to the front of the tag. Now I use those tiny attachers as kind of the veins. So, and then it held on my sentiment piece as well. So I didn't have to add any adhesive to the sentiment piece or the holly leaves. I added a couple of gems there. You've seen me use these before. These are from Michaels. And then I'm just taking some of the string and adding it through the hole of the tag. Now this hole was already pre-cut for me, so once again, that saved me time. And this string will just kind of dangle from the tag when I'm all done. And then you can see there's my tag there. I can just write on there to Elliot from Dad and Mom. And that completes my tag. Lots of easy tags. I made about 27 and I think it took me less than an hour because I used a bunch of cheats on this, like my little stapler and my washi tape and some pre-made tags as well. Now I wanted to show you, I'm going to cheat even more when I attach these to my gifts because I'm going to add a glue dot to the back of these. I'm going to leave the backer on it. And then when I'm ready to attach it to my gift, I can just take off that backer and stick them to my gift under the bow. So once again, a look at my finished handmade gift tags in a hurry for the Christmas season. You can see links to all of these products used in this project at my blog at sprinkledwithglitter.com, also in the description at YouTube. Thanks for stopping by. I hope you have a fabulous day and a very Merry Christmas.